So I get, you know what? Since we got the cameras rolling and the audio going, I'm going to do, I really need to stick it to her. I'm going to try. Okay, so I read that the average person takes about 20 minutes, 20 to 22 minutes to fall asleep at night. I don't know if anybody else has heard this or made this fact up also. Since we got these cameras, I'm gonna break a record tonight. Average person takes 20 minutes to fall asleep. To prove to my soon-to-be facially disfigured, hopefully, ex-wife, I'm gonna fall asleep in three. 3 minutes. I'm talking REM. I'm talking I could toot, I could snore. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I don't know what I look like when I sleep. I don't know if there's any freaks out here that film themselves sleeping. I don't. And obviously I'm not gonna just like make y'all watch me try and sleep for 3 minutes. I'm not, you know, I'm a professional. So I brought a buddy, I flew in a buddy, John, old friend of mine. I haven't seen him in about 10 years. John's gonna come up here and entertain you while I break a world record. So y'all are witnessing not only history, but maybe I can get my kids out of this. Okay. So 3 minutes. Start time.
Hey Ryan, I'm not a stand-up comedian. I I know Ryan from our youth group, but. I brought a couple emails. He said I could do whatever I want. I brought a couple funny emails that I'm gonna, I guess, read to you while he tries to sleep. I don't really understand the. All right. Man dies and goes to heaven. St. Peter meets him at the pearly gates. St. Peter says, here's how it works. You need 100 points to make it into heaven. You tell me all the good things you've done, I'll give you a certain number of points for each item, depending on how good it was. When you reach 100 points, you get in. Okay, the man says. Well, I attended church every Sunday. Well, that's good, said St. Peter. That's worth 2 points. 2 points, he says. Well, I gave 10% of all my earnings to the church. Well, let's see, answers Peter. That's worth another 2 points. Did you do anything else? 2 points? Golly! How about this? I started a soup kitchen in my city and worked in a shelter for homeless veterans. Fantastic. That's certainly worth a point, he says. I was married to the same woman for 50 years, never cheated on her, even in my heart. That's wonderful, says St. Peter. That's worth 3 points. 3 points, the man cries. At this rate, the only way I get into heaven is by the grace of God. Well, come on in, says St. Peter. That just kills me. I'll do a couple more. A man walked into a gift shop that sold religious items. Near the cash register, he saw a display of caps with WWJD printed on them. He was puzzled over what the letters meant, but he couldn't figure it out, so he asked the clerk. The clerk replied that the letter stood for What Would Jesus Do? And was meant to inspire people not to make rash decisions, but rather to imagine what Jesus would do in the same situation. The man thought for a moment and then replied, well, I'm sure Jesus wouldn't pay $17.95 for one of these caps. I got one more. Well, yeah. Okay. A man goes into a greasy spoon restaurant and orders a bowl of chicken soup. What's this? He screams. There's a pussy hair in my soup. I'm not paying for it. And he storms out. The waitress gets very upset and follows him out and sees him go to the whorehouse across the street. He pays the madam and retires to a room with a lovely blonde and goes down on her with gusto. The waitress bursts in and says, you complain about a hair in your soup and then come over here and do this? The waitress yells. He lifts his head, turns to her and says, yeah, and if I find a noodle in here, I ain't paying for it either. About 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, Ryan?
Damn it.
Oh, Thank y'all.
Thanks, John. It's good to see you, man. Shit.